Hi, my name is Michael Smith. I'm one of the co-founders here at New Reality Network. And today, in this video, we wanted to basically cover something that we haven't really featured on much of in regards to the other content that we've been doing. So while we've focused on creating 360-degree and VR media content for things like journalism and broadcasting and podcasts and stuff, one element we haven't really focused on is gaming. And obviously that's quite an important thing given that gaming's a massive driver of VR and 360-degree technology. So we wanted to do a brief video to kind of show you some of the cool developments that have come out of PC gaming, really. So we wanted to talk about NVIDIA's Ansel. So here at New Reality Network, we actually use Republic of Gamers, ASUS Strix gaming PC, that features a NVIDIA GTX 1060 graphics card. And that's kind of benchmark when working with VR, especially if you're using the HTC Vive. But it also comes with a kind of range of benefits. So one of these benefits is NVIDIA's Ansel technology, which allows you to essentially take 360-degree photos from within your games. Now, bearing in mind, the games do have to actually support the technology, but it is something that we anticipate that NVIDIA will continue to push with games developers to have it featured in more games. So at the moment, as you can see on the web browser here, NVIDIA do list all the games that are compatible there. So for example, one of the biggest releases so far this year, Mass Effect Andromeda, is on there. You've got Ghost Recon, For Honor, one of my favourites there, Mirror's Edge Catalyst. And all these games, are, you know, you can purchase from the various online PC stores, download them, and Ansel's built into them. So the two games we're going to focus on, really, especially if you don't want to necessarily spend a lot of money is on these games, is Paragon and War Thunder. And we're going to show you how you can capture 360-degree photos in-game with that. So the first up, we'll focus on War Thunder. So we've downloaded, installed the game, and we've got it running now. So let's just go back to the main menu here. So every time you complete a battle in War Thunder, you'll have a replay, a video replay saved for you on their servers, which you'll be able to go back and watch and record and download and so on. What's interesting about this is you don't actually need to be in a battle, but it's kind of cool that you can capture you know, the key elements of battle and the replay, and the video system is actually really good in the sense that it will highlight key points for you. So for example, you can set the video playback so that it shows any kind of kills that you've done or cool maneuvers and stuff, and this is really good, especially if you're kind of flying in planes and stuff, you know, during the battles, that you can really get some interesting screenshots from here. So NVIDIA kind of made this really simple. Basically, any game that's Ansel supported, essentially you would capture the 360-degree picture as part of the playback. So in order to do this, all you need to do is essentially press Alt and F2 on your keyboard, and it will bring up the Ansel menu. So as you can see here, it's brought up a 360-degree thing where we can move the camera around, and we can roll the camera, we can change the field of view. So here we can see the field of view. Really stretch that out and getting close, and we can roll the camera. Want to do some interesting screenshots there. So for now, we're just going to set this on the standard 90 degree setting. You can actually also capture standard screenshots in hyperdynamic range, which is really cool, and you can get some beautiful screenshots. There's a whole range of settings here, so you can set this up so you can build a sketch. So if you want that kind of cartoony feel, you can really make the colours pop out and enhance them. So just from there, as you can see, we turn that all the way up to 100, and we get this really kind of really nice gritty rust effects going on in the building in the background. And if you're a fan of vinaigrette, you can obviously do that as well. You can apply grid of thirds so you get a better understanding of how you want to frame your shots that you're capturing. So these are just some of the things that you can play about with. And, you know, again, you can do things like turn the brightness up and turn it down, you know, really make colours pop out. So the most important thing we want to focus on here is really this kind of bottom menu here where it says capture type. So we've got a few options here. So this is just standard screenshot. So if you want to take a standard screenshot and frame it, just click on the, you know, you select the screenshot, click snap. But for us, we want to look at two things, really, is capturing 360 degree and capturing 360 degree stereo. Now the 360 degree stereo won't be supported by most platforms, but it will be supported locally on your PC. So if you're running a VR headset, you will be able to view that picture in full VR with stereoscopic 3D effect. But you can, but for now we're just going to capture the standard 360 degree photo, and we can really, really go to town with resolution here. All the way up to effectively 8K. In fact, I think that's probably more than 8K. But nevertheless, for the sake of this video, we're going to kind of drop down the quality to the minimum here. In fact, I'll tell you what we'll do is we'll get it to about there, because Facebook doesn't really support anything more than 6,000 pixels. By 3,000 pixels, so this is quite a nice happy ground, and this will give us a really cool resolution here. So once you've kind of set that up and you're happy with everything, simply click snap, and Ansa will render the picture for you. And as you can see here, it saved it into our drive. It tells you where it sends it, and essentially how long it's going to take. Because we've got quite a powerful PC, it hasn't taken us very long. So we're going to exit back to the desktop. We're going to go into our folder here, and you'll now see that we have the JPEG here. So all we need to do is simply go to our social media platform of choice, in this case Facebook, and we simply click on here, add photos, and we're going to add this one here. And as soon as we upload it, you'll see this icon here. This shows that it's a 360 degree picture. So we're simply going to say War Thunder test image using Ansel. In fact, let's put that as NVIDIA Ansel. Okay, and we can go ahead and publish that. And obviously you can share these on your personal timeline directly from in-game. So now, if we actually go and have a look on our Facebook page, we can zoom right in, or we can zoom out because of the way the Ansel works, and we get a really, really good detailed 360 degree photo. And we could have actually even gone higher quality than this. So this is War Thunder. Again, as I say, it's actually free to play on PC, so it's worth checking that out. And I should point out that there is a community at the moment that's rapidly growing, which is specifically 360 degree gaming photography. So, you know, it is worth considering that if you're working in this field, this is kind of a nice community that you can go and join in with, that's effectively really easy for people to get involved with. Given the fact that capturing 360 degree photos is not that difficult using NVIDIA's Ansel. So what we're going to do is we're just going to minimize this, and we're going to close down War Thunder. So now we're going to show you Paragon, which is a different kind of game. It's a MOAB. So we've got the game installed, and we're going to show how to take 360 degree photos within Paragon. So we're just going to reduce the volume a little bit. So, Paragon, as I said before, is a MOAB. So once you've completed the game, simply go into Watch, and you can see here you've got Paragon TV, and personal friends. So we're going to go into Recent Games, and we're going to look at personal. And basically, it will load up the replay for us. So it takes a little time to do. These are actually stored on Epic Server. So we've got different kinds of. We've obviously got games starting here. And we can go to any point in the footage, speed it up, try and find.
An enemy has been slain.
We'll get it somewhere near the end of the game.
An enemy has been hit. An enemy is an enemy hitter is now. An enemy hitter is now.
Okay, so there you can see my character. Get into the arc. So we've got quite a nice potential screenshot here. So again, much like what we did with War Thunder, we're going to press Alt and F2. And you'll see here, we can move around, etc. So we've got the field of view. So with this one, I kind of want to really get in close. And, just lift that out a bit. And so we're going to change this again, much like in War Thunder, to change this to 360 degrees. We might want to just move the footage forward slightly. Let's see if we can zoom out this a little bit.
The core is almost finished.
There we go. So that looks like that's going to be an amazing screenshot for us to do. So we'll go Alt F2. We're going to reduce the field of view so we can really get stuck in there. Okay, and like I said before, we're going to put this at 360 degrees. We're going to really ramp the resolution up this time. We want it to be absolutely amazing. And so we're going to snap that. And this one will take a little bit longer due to the fact that it's of the highest possible resolution. The photo itself is 1 gigabyte, which, as you can imagine, is quite a lot of data for a photo. But it will look amazing once it's done. So we're nearly there. And there we go. So as it says here, it's going to take a little while. But yep, our photo is complete. So we can be done with that. And we'll head back onto the desktop. And we're going to look at our files in the desktop capture folder. And as we can see the photo here. So we're now going to upload that to our Facebook page. select that, and we're going to go into Ryan Client. We're going to do that one. And again, you can see the icon here, and we'll just call that Paragon Test 360 Photo. So we'll just wait for it to complete its upload to Facebook, and then we're going to publish that. And there we have it. So now if we go and look at this on the 360 side of stuff, again, we can get really close in there, and we know it's a high resolution, and we can look all around the gaming environment. And for the benefit, I'll put this on full screen. We can see everything, all the lighting, explosions everywhere. So that's quite good. So yeah, and as we mentioned earlier in the video, there is a kind of growing community around producing these kinds of screenshots. So hopefully that answers any questions you might have about using NVIDIA's Ansel system for capturing 360 degree in-game photos that you can go back and edit and mess around with. That's really how to do that. So obviously we continue to publish content on New Reality Network, so do keep an eye out for us on Facebook. You've seen our Facebook page here, which is New Reality Network. Just visit us on Facebook at New Reality Network. You can also find us on Instagram, where we usually take pictures of events that we've been doing, and photo shoots and stuff like that. So if you follow us on Instagram at New Reality Network, and we're also on Twitter as well, which we regularly keep updated, and that's at New Reality Net. I've been Michael Smith. Thanks for watching, and I hope you keep checking back for more videos about how you can create 360 degree content and the kinds of things that are available for you to do so. More tips, more tutorials. So in the meantime, take care, and we'll see you on the next video.